Hello everyone, I am Sarfraz from mobilesmspk.net and today I am going to review Qmobile Noize E14. So let's get started. I have already made unboxing video of Qmobile Noize E14 and recommending you to watch that video as well. Qmobile Noize E14 is latest flagship phone from Qmobile, which has 5.5-inch Full HD IPS screen with 1080p resolution. Phone has 13-megapixel back and 8-megapixel front camera, and powered by 1.8GHz octa-core processor and 4GB of RAM. This phone is actually made by Xiaomi, which is a Chinese company, and the model name is Xiaomi S6 Pro. And Qmobile launches that mobile in Pakistan by the collaboration with Xiaomi. Only difference between Xiaomi S6 Pro and Qmobile Z14 is that S6 Pro has 64GB of internal storage while Z14 has 32GB. Same mobile is also launched by Allview, which is a Romanian company, and the model name is Allview X3 Sol Plus. Let's start with call quality of the phone. Call quality is very good, voices are crisp and clear on both ends. I have not faced any distortion during my test. Let me give you a physical overview of the phone. On the front of the phone, there is 8-megapixel camera, sensor, notification LED, 5.5-inch Full HD IPS display with 1080p resolution, and below the screen, there is a physical home button which works as fingerprint sensor. 3.5mm headphone jack on the top, volume rockers, and power button on the right, speaker grill, USB Type-C port, and main microphone on the bottom, SIM tray on the left, secondary noise cancellation mic, 13-megapixel camera along with single LED flash, and Qmobile branding on the back of the phone. There are dedicated navigational buttons, but they do not light up, so you might face problem to use them in dark. You can swap the functionality of navigational buttons, and this is how you can do that. Phone has unibody design with chamfered edges and made of aluminum. That's why there are antenna lines on the back of the phone, so signals can pass through it. Build quality of Noize E14 is very premium. Phone feels solid and sturdy, and despite being made of aluminum, phone is not heavy at all. Let me show you the weight of the phone. Fingerprint sensor on Z14 is very fast and responsive. Let me show you how fast it is. Button is clickable, but to unlock the device, you only need to tap on that. You need to wake up the phone first to use fingerprint sensor. This is how you can add fingerprint on Qmobile Z14. Qmobile Noize E14 has 32GB of internal storage, from which around 23GB is available out of the box. You can always expand internal storage through microSD card slot. Phone supports up to 128GB card. Phone comes with 4GB of RAM, from which 2.5GB is available on first boot. Qmobile Noize E14 has 4G capabilities and has hybrid SIM slot, so you can use either two SIMs or one SIM and microSD card at a time. Sound is loud and clear. It is always good to have speakers at the bottom of the phone rather than on the back, so if your phone lying on the desk, speaker won't get muffled. Even though it looks like phone has dual speakers, but speaker is only on right side. Let me show you how loud the speaker is. Qmobile Noir Z14 has 5.5-inch Full HD IPS display with 1080p resolution. Display looks bright and sharp, colors look vivid and saturation is good. Viewing angles are impressive of the phone. Display is made of 2.5D curved glass, but unfortunately there is no Gorilla Glass protection. Let me show you loyalty fee video to give you idea about multimedia experience of the phone. Sunlight visibility of Z14 is acceptable. Because it is Full HD display, I was hoping that phone display will perform better in direct sunlight. But it was below par of my expectation. You need to crank up the brightness to full to use it in outdoor. There is a theme park app installed on the phone which provides 3 additional themes, and this is how they looks like. And if you don't like themes available on Theme Park app, then you can create custom themes on Chameleon app. This is how you can create theme using Chameleon. Noir Z14 is powered by 1.8 GHz octa-core processor with MediaTek MT6755 Helio P10 chipset. Phone has 4GB of RAM and Mali-T860 GPU. Z14 hardware is very powerful and comes with numerous sensors like accelerometer, proximity, motion, gyroscope, magnetic, light, and gravity sensors. Let me show you the benchmark scores. Here is the AnTuTu score. Here is the Geekbench score. Day-to-day performance of the phone is very fast, and I have not noticed any lags or hiccups thanks to the 4GB available RAM. Phone supports up to 5 finger touch. Phone does support OTG, and you can run media files directly from external pen drive. Qmobile Noir Z14 runs on Android Marshmallow 6.0 with Amigo 3.2 UI. This UI comes with only Xiaomi phones, so whenever you see this UI, you can guess that phone must be made by Xiaomi. I personally don't prefer custom UI because of two main reasons. First, it consumes lots of space and RAM on the phone, and Amigo UI is not exception. It consumes almost 1.2 GB of RAM. And the second reason is lack of app drawer. However, you can fix this problem by using custom launchers like Nova or Google Now launchers. Amigo UI is inspired by iOS, and just like iOS, notification slider is located at the top. And to access quick toggle slider, you need to slide up from the bottom. There is a fake call option available on the phone, which mimics like a real call, and you will get a fake call after 15 seconds. If you want to take a screenshot of long screen, then you can do so by using Super Screenshot option. This is how you can do that. If you are running out of battery and don't have facility to charge the phone, then you can switch your phone to extreme power saving mode. On this mode, you can only perform basic tasks on the phone, but on the other hand, your phone battery can survive for several more hours. Let's take a look at some additional features available in the advanced setting menu. Phone has Edge by feature, from which you can add shortcuts of your favorite apps to this Edge bar. And to access Edge bar, you just need to swipe on home button from either left or right. You can add or remove applications from Edge bar. There are number of gestures available on the phone like smart dial, smart answer, pause alarm, black screen gestures, smart vibration reminder, smart bright screen, and double tap to wake. Let me show you a couple of them. As name suggests, you can wake up the phone by double tapping on the screen. Here is the black screen gestures, from which you can open certain apps by drawing symbols on the screen when phone is on sleeping mode. You can also assign apps to some of the available symbols. There is an option to set schedule time to power off or on the phone automatically. This feature is useful if you want to power off the phone at night hours while sleeping. Q-Mobile phones usually comes with numbers of bloatwares, and this phone is not exception. Some useful apps are pre-installed on the phone like File Manager, System Manager, Facebook, WhatsApp, Theme Park and Chameleon. There is a GameLoad folder which contains 4 games, and these games cannot be deleted, and because these are only trial versions, so you cannot play them either, but you can disable them. Q-Mobile Noir Z14 is powered by 3130 mAh non-removable battery. I usually prefer user replaceable battery, and because Z14 is expensive phone and has a non-removable battery, so I suggest you to use good quality power bank to charge your phone. Battery timing on Q-Mobile Noir Z14 is average. I get around 3.5 hours of screen on time with maximum brightness during my testing. So it is quite possible you might get better battery timing. it takes around 2 hours to charge the phone. Phone has gyroscope sensor and supports VR, so you can use any application or game which provides VR functionality. Qmobile Z14 comes with 13-megapixel back and 8-megapixel front camera. Quality of both front and back camera is excellent, interface is very intuitive. There are number of modes available on the phone. You can pause this video to watch them all. To cut video time short, I am not going into the details of these modes. Front flash is missing on the phone, but you can use screen flash to take selfies in dark environments. Phone can capture up to 1080p videos. Let me show you shutter speed and image quality of the phone. Here is picture result of 13-megapixel back camera. So here is my final verdict on Qmobile Z14. Do I recommend this phone? Yes, I do. Phone has good build quality, responsive fingerprint sensor, vibrant screen, excellent camera, powerful hardware. There are so many areas in which this phone excels. Only thing disappoints me is battery life. It is not bad by any means, but it could have been better. I will upload gaming review of Qmobile Noi Z14 soon. So if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, please do it now. If you like this video, please hit the like button. If you have any questions, feedbacks or suggestions, do let me know in the comment section below. For more information, please do visit my website.